Alrighty, welcome to a vintage video here on channelfireball.com. Playing some slightly different cards here than the normal mentor list. Got Young Pyromancer instead. Totally different. Actually, this is a slightly different strategy where it's called a Delverino, but really it's just blue-red Delver. And what this deck is trying to do, still playing the core blue cards of, you know, Force of Will, the broken cards like Ancestral, you know, Time Walk, Mental Misstep, but instead of playing more mana and Monastery Mentor, it's got fewer mana artifacts, just the Mox Ruby, Sapphire, and Lotus, and then Null Rod in the main deck, Null Rod in the sideboard. Though the Mentor deck I like has Sunny Silence as well. Slightly more aggressive, 4 Delver of Secrets, the 1 mana 3-2 flyer, 4 Lightning Bolt, again the 4 Pyromancer which are cheap, a Snapcaster and a Jace, and then a Sulfur Elemental, hose those pesky Mentor players, plus a little splash damage against White Eldrazi, Kilthalia and all that, a pair of Spell Pierces, a Daze even, and then 4 Wastelands, don't judge me, one off-brand Wasteland, and of course a Strip Mine, and so a lower curve, more ones, slightly more aggressive bent, and in exchange you get to play kind of the same amount of mana sources, but 4 Wastelands and a Strip Mine means you're a lot more aggressive in attacking the mana. I'm actually not sure you're not supposed to have 2 Null Rods in the main deck. I waffled back and forth. So Null Rod in the sideboard. You like these against all the big mana decks and the current version of Mishra's Workshop that has Hangerback Walker and Arcbound Ravager, among other things. Jace against control decks, Flusterstorm against storm and control decks, Mindbreak Trap against combo, 2 Ravenous Trap, 3 Grafdigger's Cage against dredge. That's a little light. I think this deck might want one more anti-dredge card. Biforce and 4 Ingot Chewers against workshops. Also notice that there is a snow-covered mountain in the main deck. Snow-covered, very important. It's not, I just like the pictures and it's easy to search for. But it means you have the basic mount in the sideboard, you don't need to search it up. Another Sulfur Elemental. And that'll do it. Let's join a daily event and see how we do. Alrighty, time for round one. Ooh, I will keep this hand. It's got double misstep plus force plus spell pierces disruption and a Delver. So this is a nice little one lander. And pretty good against a blue deck. So I'm gonna lead with Delver on turn one here. If I had a second land, I would think about leading on Spell Pierce and then having Delver up after that, but because I don't, I'd rather just play the Delver and start getting pressure going. Even then, I probably would still just play the Delver, even if I had a second land. Opponent had no play on turn one. That's interesting. That narrows down the deck a little bit. All right. Sadly, my misstep's not getting a ton of value here, but decent chance I want to Force of Will something here. Let's see what it is. Jace Vryn's Prodigy. That I'm actually going to let go. I've got a bunch of Lightning Bolts in my deck. That's not super relevant, but more, I think I can let my opponent do that. I do not want to reveal Black Lotus. Well, that means if I draw a red source, I get to cast it. I'm actually not even going to play the Lotus. I don't think I need to. I can cast Spell Pierce. And I can cast everything else for free. So, and I can't quite cast Gush. So let's see what my opponent is up to. Jace is not intrinsically card advantage. I don't know, maybe I should have countered Jace. I have a creature in play, so I can potentially attack Jace at some point. And like I said, I've got Lightning Bolts, which are good against either side of Jace, though. Clearly much better against this one. Paradoxical Outcome. All right. Here's where I wish I had a second Null Rod. This is like a Mentor deck with Paradoxical Outcomes. What do they have here? They don't have a Mentor because they played the Petal first. They're sacking the Underground Sea. Are they going big? Tinker? Oh, I like seeing that. This is the kind of fight I don't mind. They have 3 cards in their hand. Wouldn't mind if they had Mental Misstep. Force of Will is alright. Alright, so they have Mental Misstep, so I Mental Misstep their Misstep. And let's see, do they have Tinker with Force Backup? And Mental Misstep? Wow, that's a lot of stuff. Okay, so Thirst for Knowledge. Alright, so they countered the Spell Pierce. Missteps resolved. They have no cards in their hand. Alright, I'm going to force pitching Mental Misstep. And now I get to hopefully... land means I can cast Gush, which I wouldn't mind. Spell, of course, means I get to flip Delver and have a sweet spell. Lightning Bolt. Yeah, I'm going to have to... Sadly, this Lotus is going the way I'm force of will. I'm kind of like force of willing the Jace. I'm pitching Lotus and a Bolt, but this leaves us both with no cards in hand. Well, my opponent with no cards in hand, me with a force and a blue card, but they don't have anything that I have to play, so I really just want to draw land so I can flip into Gush. Treasure Cruise would, of course, be nice as well. Alright, no plays. Jace, well, Jace at least, let's see, given the composition of my graveyard, I would probably pitch Jace to Force of Will before I pitched Gush at this point. Also, I only need to hit my opponent three more times with Delver. Mystical Tutor, oof, that was really good for me. I would rather my opponent not draw anything good, but if they're going to draw something good, might as well have it be a Mystical Tutor, which lets them go get a card, put it on top, and then I get to Force of Will it on my turn, or on their next turn, so they skipped multiple draws. They got Ancestral Recall. Yes, that's getting Force of Will. Now I wish I'd kept a Mental Misstep. All right. I'm going to exile Jace. I guess I could have exiled Gush because I have the Lightning Bolt's now lethal, or very close to lethal. Yeah, that's close. Why now, Mental Misstep? Why now? All right. Let's attack. Pass the turn. It's on six. They have two draw steps to draw relevant cards, and they have a lot of bricks in their deck now, because Paradoxical Outcomes don't do anything, Force Wills don't do anything, random mana artifacts don't do much. Ooh, Preordain. That is nice. Alright, bottom, top, Scalding Tarn. I'm going to get a Volcanic, crack for red, and cast Gush, I think. This way, if I draw a Bolt, I can just win. All right, well, I didn't, funnily enough, I drew a blue card, but I also drew a Mock Sapphire, so I get to still play Delver. And then now, well, this doesn't actually speed up the clock at all, does it? Because my opponent's on three. I'll play it anyway. So my opponent had turn three Tinker with Misstep Force backup. I had a lot of counters. That was good for me. Since he's Divining Top, I will Mental Misstep that for sure. And that should end the game here. All right. Post board, I get Norrod, Flusterstorm, Mindbreak Trap. I get to take out. Lightning Bolt's normally a card I would take out, but if my opponent's running Jace Vryn's Prodigy, and I'm a little more inclined to keep it in, I don't know if they have Monastery Mentor, given what I've seen. Some of the outcome decks do, some do not. I'd say more do than don't. I'm still going to take out probably two Bolts. And maybe I'll just take out a Pyromancer here. I'm just going to take out Sulfur Elemental. If they have Mentor, I guess I'll figure that out. Alrighty, time for game two. I'm going to keep this hand, though. Obviously, I drew all the Lightning Bolts. Whatever. Flusterstorm's good. Jace and Dak both get rid of these excess Lightning Bolts, so I'm not super worried. Turn on Sol Ring. That's annoying. Alright. If I can resolve a Norrod, my opponent's deck basically can't win, or it's very difficult for them to win. So, it'd be nice if I could pick one of those up. Glad I put those two in, though. I would like to see one soon. If I draw Lotus on turn one, that would be awesome, because then I could play turn one Dak and steal Sol Ring. But otherwise, it's pretty hard to get Dak out early. I'm going to play Islands such that I have Flusterstorm up on turn two. I actually will brainstorm end of turn if my opponent doesn't do anything. I don't have time to mess around here. Not against a Sol Ring opener. And I wonder if I should have had a couple Sulfur Elementals in the deck. Maybe they're just so likely to be playing Monastery Mentor. That's better. All right, Mox Jet is fine. Because I can't do anything about it. I can counter Paradoxical Outcome. No plays. All right, well, I'm still going to cast Brainstorm. If they want to outcome end of turn, I guess they can. And they want to. Well, it's not the end of the world. I guess it's a draw four, because they get to tap top to draw a card and then outcome in response. All right. And I'm going to draw three, kind of. Also, they have to discard a bunch of cards, so if they don't have a Mental Misstep here, this is actually not that bad for me. Ooh, all right. So now my opponents discard two cards? Sure. They cast Careful Consideration. They cast Draw 4, Discard 2. That I'm going to list as acceptable. And then on my turn, they discarded Thirst for Knowledge when they have Moxen and whatnot abound. I don't think they have Misstep, because if they had Misstep, they would almost assuredly have snapped it off on the Brainstorm to have to discard one less card. So, oh, they have to discard three. They draw four. Yeah, that was careful consideration. As instant speed, draw four, discard three. And it cost them two mana off Sol Ring and top. I actually don't even know if that was good. the end of turn outcome is something. They discard Mana Drain. So, I have a Lightning Bolt on top. I think I'm going to cast Ancestral here. Actually, I think I'm going to Ponder. I'll cast Ancestral at some point. Yes, now I can shuffle this. Hope to draw blue. No, I didn't draw blue, but Mental Misstep's still pretty good. And at least now I can represent Pyroblast. This mountain is costing me dearly here. Just let me shuffle away that Lightning Bolt at the very least. Moxjet will resolve. Soaring will not. I really wanted to have Flusterstorm up, but can't have everything. Counter your Soaring, which is really going to set my opponent back mana-wise. And they're going to play a Sensei's Divining Top. I'm probably going to counter that too. I just don't think they have any missteps in their hand. So there's not that much I want to misstep here. Oof, with Academy out, I'm glad I countered all those things. Oh, well, I got debated, and Ancestral Recall did resolve. But they already played a land. So I wish I had that Wasteland. All right, let's draw Blue Source. Not a Blue Source, but Force Will is pretty good. I'll attempt to Ancestral myself. Hopefully I don't get misstepped. No misstep, but I didn't draw a land. Oh, that's brutal. I'm going to discard a young Pyromancer, I think. I want to keep Bolt in case my opponent plays a Jace, and I want to keep all my blue cards for Force of Will. It's been a weird game. We both discarded to hand size. I really need to find Wasteland, too. That Tarn Academy is tapping for lots of mana. Sensei's Top, I'm going to Mental Misstep that. The fact that Sensei Top essentially taps for a blue mana because of Tolarian Academy, I mean, it's pretty easy misstep. I could also draw Nolrod. Nolrod would be good. And my first, what am I pitching to Force first if my opponent plays like a Tinker or something that I have to counter? It's tough, because like, I don't want to pitch Dak because I want to steal Moxjet. But I also don't want to pitch Jace, because if I don't draw a land, I can play Jace. So I guess I pitch Flusterstorm, and I'm certainly not pitching Force of Will, because if I have to get into a counter battle, I'm going to need both Force of Wills. And my opponent's on five cards in hand. This has been quite the attrition war. Let's see. So we've both resolved Ancestrals. We've both discarded to hand size, though my opponent discarded more. Wasteland. Oh, wow. Yes. Yes, we'll be Wastelanding. So the question is, do I Wasteland Academy? Actually, I think I just play Dak Faden. Because what Dak does is, I'm getting mana drained. Oh, Thirst. Thirst, I think, is fine. Because if they have to discard an artifact, it makes their Academy a little worse. And really want Dak to resolve and then have Force of Wills up to protect. Because they just have better cards. All right, explosives, sure. And I'm going to steal Moxjet if Dak resolves. If they force, I'm going to force pitching Flusterstorm. We're getting to the point where I don't think I'm going to have untapped blue anyway. So basically, Wasteland cuts my opponent off of 2 mana currently, and Dak also cuts my opponent off of 2 mana, though I suppose Tolarian Academy could be more mana in the future. Alright, Moxjet, you're getting over here so I can have more mana for my activities. 6 cards. They have access to 3 mana, but they could ramp that up significantly. Okay, Delta. What is going on? And with Dak in play, I can just pitch everything to Force and not care, because Dak will draw me the cards I need. Demonic Tutor, sure. In general, in Vintage right now, I like letting Tutor resolve, just because you can just counter whatever they're playing off Tutor a lot of the time. I hope I don't get Mind's Desired here. But if I do, it's for like 3. If this is a Yawgmoth's will. But they didn't tap their academy. Okay. So it has to be Yawgmoth's will, then otherwise they'd have tapped academy first. Which, now they don't want to because they're going to cast will and they want it to resolve, then play all the artifacts, then tap academy. Alright. Force pitching Flusterstorm. They're going to counter back, I'm sure of it. Force pitching repeal. Well, if this resolves, I lose, so I should probably force it again. Don't have another counter, please. Don't do it. Alright. They have two cards in hand. They don't have any artifacts in play. About to wasteland their underground seed, probably. They were going to definitely win if that resolved. I also get to DAC to draw into some action here. This is all going great. Alright, I could preordain first, I guess. Yeah, let's preordain first. Ooh. Okay, let's just put them both on top. Then discard Lightning Bolt. Oh, wow. Actually, I'm going to discard Scalding Tarn. New plan. Play Null Rod. And Wasteland your Underground Sea. And then pass. I can just Treasure Cruise next turn. I was going to use Scalding Tarn to Treasure Cruise this turn, but no reason to wait, not to wait a turn here. Okay. The tap's for blue, but that's about it. Opponent has Mana Drain mana up. Also, I can start DACing my opponent's artifacts if I want to at some point. I don't want to right now, though. Ooh, Daze is nice. Alright. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I mean, I have Snapcaster, and I guess Jace is gone. So I have Snapcaster, so I want to leave Ancestral and, like, Misstep in the graveyard. Alright. DAC Faden doing what he does best. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Kind of want all of this stuff. I'm definitely discarding Null Rod. The question is, what do I discard next? Actually, I'm just going to discard Volcanic, play Wasteland, and Waste Academy. Snapcaster Mage? Just as a creature to attack DAC? I guess I'm going to Daze that. I don't really want my DAC getting attacked. Alright, and then next turn I can like play a Delver and then turn up for that, I guess, Time Walk or something along those lines. My opponent on not very many mana sources. I like my hand a good amount, but could always use more options. Kind of want to discard, yeah, Delver, Spell Pierce, play a land, play Delver. I want to keep one of the Delvers because I do want to kill my opponent at some point. And I like Gush with DAC Faden. If I can draw another island, I can have plenty of ammunition to discard. Plus Time Walk with DAC and Delver in play is very good. But I think it's almost academic at this point. I don't want to reveal Snow-Covered Island. So what I'm going to do here, I'm just going to DAC. I'm going to try to Gush next turn, I think. All right, Mindbreak Trap and Wasteland can get discarded. Land, Time Walk. Hit for one. Next turn, I'm gonna float two blue, Gush, and then use DAC and have all the options in the world. All right, flip. No? Well, Black Lotus I can discard, given that I have Null Rod in play. I probably need like one more counterspell just to like lock this completely, though. I don't even know if that's true. Wow, okay. Well, Snapcaster is going to be great here. So let's discard Black Lotus and Island. Let's go. I think I just want to end this, so I'm just going to go Snapcaster, Time Walk. Because that just does the most damage. Gets me a DAC activation. And then next turn I can dig through time as well. If I find Strip Mine, that's like the full lock here. I guess I can't play it next turn if I dig into it, but that's okay. I'm gonna get to see three new cards off of DAC. Delver of Secrets. Well, let's discard I'm definitely discarding a Delver. And I guess a Wasteland, and let's go play Scalding Tarn, crack it for blue, cast Preordain. Alright, so I'm going to put these both on top. I'm going to play Delver. And this way both my Delvers will flip next turn. See, my opponent only has three cards in hand, so I'm not really worried about them staging some kind of miracle comeback next turn. Like, they need a way to bounce Null Rudd and something really good. They're like multiple turns away from just casting Tinker. When I reveal Force of Will to Delver next turn, I think they're just going to concede, as they should. Alright. And just keep decking. Alright. Don't need Pyromancers at all. Just hit my opponent down to 4. Oh, they have Repeal. No, Repeal doesn't work on a Flip Delver anymore. This actually still costs 1. It's just a rules change, which has made my beloved Repeals even worse. Honestly, it's probably good for me because I shouldn't have been playing Repeal, and now that means I had no excuse to even try. They can Repeal a Moxjet if that's what they really want to do. But I think we've got a round 1 victory here. Let my opponent... Oh, dismember and dead. That works for me. Alrighty, welcome to round 2. I'm on the draw. Oh, I'm going to keep this hand. No island for Daze, but I can just pitch Daze to Force of Will. Slightly awkward combination of Mox Sapphire and Null Rod. Null Rod, one of the best flavor techs in the game. But they're also both just good cards. Tundra. Mentor? Sensei's Divine Top. Ooh, I like saying top because I get to Null Rod that into oblivion. Oh yes, Nolrod's going to be good here. Now I'm a little scared. What's going on here? Preordain is fine. I hope my opponent doesn't have anything to play turn 1 at this Lotus, then I can just slam Nolrod. I really just want to draw Volcanic Island. Monastery Mentor or that, I'm going to Force a Will. Pitching Daze, and if my opponent has Force, then I'm in trouble. Don't do it. Turn 1 Mentor with Force backup. Well, this is how we lose. All right. If I preordain, I need to draw 1 of Lightning Bolt or Volcanic. I need to preordain into an answer, I guess. I could play Nolrod, but at this point, I'm just losing to Mentor. Well, there's Lightning Bolt. All right, I guess I keep that, and I think I do Wasteland here. If my opponent can't play Sensei's Divining Top, which is their top card. If they don't have a land, just don't have a land as your last card, then they can't play anything. Okay, so now if I draw red, I can kill the Mentor. And then I actually think we're winning. Red, 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 red. Not quite there. Let's see. I think I just play Delver and have Spell Pierce up. Oh, race to red. Could I draw red before my opponent draws a land? Mox, okay, well that doesn't do that much. It gets them a monk token, but I can outrace a monk token. Alright, I'm gonna take 3. Going to 14. Red source, red source, red source. Do I want to reveal this card? Yes. Okay, ponder is actually great, because now I can ponder into a red source. I hope that, oof. Oh wow, so Sulfur Elemental and Pyromancer. So actually what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put these on top. Yeah, I think this is fine, because then I can preordain, put Pyromancer on the bottom, Sulfur Elemental on top, and what's great about this is that I'm not going to attack, so I'm going to offer it a Mentor trade. If I draw red now, it doesn't matter if my opponent has kind of gone off, which, of course, they drew a land right now, but then I get to Sulfur Elemental all their monk tokens away. All right, so despite my opponent peeling the land, though they hit it on their second draw step, I guess. I'm taking 7 now. Wow, they're really going off, aren't they? Okay, I'm taking 9. All right. If my top cards are red, I still think I just win this game. But it has to be the top card now. And I know, I guess, the problem is if I play Nolrod, I can't play Sulfur Elemental next turn. Wow. This is a brutal game to lose, honestly. Well, alright. Put another Sulfur Elemental and another Null Rod in. What am I cutting against these decks? I actually do like Lightning Bolts. Actually, this is probably why I don't have too many sideboard cards. Spell Pierce is fine. It doesn't counter Mentor, but it counters everything else. Daze I don't like as much. Daze on the play might still be good. I don't know. And probably I can cut like a Delver as well. I don't think I want Biforce. I'm just going to rely on my Null Rods to do that work. All right. I would like to play first. Mm-hmm. And I'll keep this. Put this on the bottom. And I think I just pass. Their deck's so explosive, I want to keep up Spell Pierce on turn one. Because Spell Piercing, yeah, like Mana Crypt is just great. Well, if they have Mental Misstep, they have Mental Misstep. Oh, they're going to force it? That's not good news for me. Okay. You've got a Mana Crypt. And a Soul Ring. And what else? They have turn one Paradoxical Outcome. No, Time Walk. Plus Gitaxian Probe, sure. If I draw an Null Rod, I'm still in good shape, but if my opponent has a turn two Mentor here, then I'm in trouble. The good thing is both Null Rod and Sulfur Elemental clean up a lot of messes. Like, I can be fairly behind and have those cards and just, you know, end up in a pretty good spot. I don't like what's happening, whatever it is. Thoughtcast, sure. My opponent's hands have been broken. If this is Paradoxical Outcome Academy and a Preordain, okay. Just once, honestly. can we get some mercy? A little bit of mercy? Alright, Mentor. Now I actually do want to see. They put both on top so that they know what their next card is. Alright. Okay. Okay. I'm not complaining about that. Delver I don't want, I don't think. They can't counter Sulfur Elemental, so let's just pass and see what they play. They take some damage. I like that. One drop? Oh, I get to misstep it? Alright, we're actually winning now, I think, because we get the first draw step. I guess my opponent has a million mana. No, we're not winning. We're not losing, but I guess they have a Mana Crypt out is the other thing. Alright. Sulfur Elemental, I need to draw something good here. Lightning Bolt. Actually, don't think I bolt the Mentor. I'm just going to save a bolt for my opponent. They need to start losing some Mana Crypt flips. That's what we need. No. Because if they draw a Paradoxical Outcome or anything like that, then we're just going to take a ton of damage. Also, they're just going to draw a million cards, and they're just going to win. Ooh. Wasteland on Academy helps a little bit. It doesn't help that much, honestly. Because they already have tons of mana. Can you just lose a Mana Crypt flip just once? Yeah. Actually, they already lost one, but who's counting? The answer is I'm counting. Sure. Make no token. 4-2. Oh no. Not like this. Like this. Because now they get to outcome and... ugh. They get to not replay their... so this is a 4-2, so it's going to be 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, so I guess I have to bolt the Mentor now, otherwise I think I'm just going to die. Okay. Now I'm definitely losing. Like, my opponent just drew 4 cards and has a ton of mana. I mean, I drew the Wasteland, so they don't have, like, infinite mana, but... this can't be good for me. Okay. Their hand is Mana Crypt and who knows what else, and they're at one now? Alright. Maybe we're not dead. They're gonna hard cast Force of Will now. Sure. That is acceptable. Can you just die to my Sulfur Elemental? It's kind of possible they can. Alright, didn't think I was winning that game. Yeah, why did I not have Mindbreak Trap in the deck? I don't know. That's a good question. Same with Flusterstorm. Actually, I'm just kind of off Delvers, I think. I want a mix of Pyromancers and Delvers. I think I want some Delvers because they're blue cards to pitch to force and they're cheaper, but I want some Pyromancers because they can hit a little bit harder over the entire course of the game. Alright. So what do I want in my opener? Yeah, this is good enough. The old Nolrod Sapphire plan again, but that's okay. The fact that I've got a 0-mana counter and 2 1-mana counters and a Nolrod, which Nolrod's just one of the best cards against them. Are they just going to play a turn 1 Mentor and I'm just going to lose? Probably. Sure. Okay. Can I just draw Black Lotus? Is that too much to ask for, honestly? Probably is. Okay. No, Forcible is not the worst. My hand's kind of obviously full of counterspells, given that I have Mock Sapphire Go, but Mana Crypt has a real drawback against my deck. So, it does prompt my opponent to play some cards here. No Academy. Alright, Mentor, I'm gonna Force. Luckily I drew the Force. That was quite lucky. Pitch Spell Pierce. Because I can Flusterstorm now. They played a bunch of spells, so this should be good enough unless they have... If they have another Force, then... C'est la vie. Okay, so Mentor down. They only have 2 cards in their hand. If I draw a land, I'm just playing Nolrod. And that's just going to put them in a position which hopefully they can't cast much. Thought cast. Okay. See, that gets Nolrodded as well. Land. Lotus would be great, because then I could play Pyromancer too. Oh, man. If I... losing to someone with 5 artifact mana in play when I have Nolrod in my hand. Come on. Alright, they're just getting whacked by their Mana Crypt. Brainstorm. Alright, Misstep. Hopefully that makes them pass the turn. No! Not like this. Is this a paradoxical outcome? It is. Okay, it's a draw 3. That's not the end of the world. It's not good, though. If I get to 2 mana and can play this Nolrod... Alright. Come on, Delverino. classic. I'm just going to play Pyromancer now. The fact that if I play Nolrod, cuts off all my mana sources, and they have 2 mana in play, and their hand is a bunch of mana sources. They have swords? Sure. I guess. Mystic Remora. Okay. So this is a weird card. Whenever I play a non-creature spell, they draw a card unless I pay 4 mana. That's fine. Alright. Need Delver to flip. Flip. Alright, time to draw. Let them draw a card and kill 2 of my own mana. But if Nolrod resolves, it's pretty good for me. So they're down to 2 mana. Their hand still has 2 more artifacts that produce mana. I'm really happy with them paying for Remora, because I can't cast anything. I mean, I can cast Lightning Bolt, but I'm not going to cast it. Okay. Do they have Fragmentize or something? Oh, they have Academy? Hey. It's funny, like, I actually won a game, and I came very close to winning the other 2 games. But I feel like I've been losing every turn of every game by a small amount. Yeah. I'm just dead now. Like, they've just drawn too many cards. They have to have an answer to Nolrod in their deck. That deck's going to play a couple Fragmentizes. Sure. Like, yeah, they're gonna swords the Delver. So I guess I need to draw a wasteland. They should play their cards, otherwise they're just gonna discard. Okay, that doesn't make any sense. Unless they have Mentor in hand. Yeah, that really needed to be a wasteland. I guess I should play it in case I draw a Gush, but. Let's see. No, you need one more arena to play Mentor. You gotta play one of your Moxerinos. Alright, there comes Monastery Mentor. I get to bolt it at least. Yeah. They draw their card. They counter a lightning bolt and make a token or something like that. That would be... yeah. Bad. Alright. I think I'm just dead now. Like, I can't draw Sulfur Elemental into land because I only have 2 mana in play. Preordain, giving them a Remora. I want to scoop rather than giving them a Remora thing, but yeah, I'll look, why not? Maybe I'll find what I'm looking for. No, that's too much. That's too much. Whatever. I have been soundly defeated, so we'll move on to round 3. Ooh. Alrighty, time for round 3. Let's see if we can rally here. Yeah, this is a good hand. I'm certainly keeping this. One thing, thinking more about round 2, is felt like we were very close to winning, but we were also playing against a deck that sees a lot more cards. This deck does not see as many cards, at least. It doesn't have that many fewer card draw spells, but the hands I had were less conducive to drawing cards. And as a result, I ended up... it's not a big surprise. I ended up like a little short. My opponent had enough stuff. Ooh, workshops. Okay. I actually don't mind playing as workshops with this deck, though. I guess I wish I had kept up Spell Pierce now. Delver is very good against workshops, though. And if my opponent has no more plays and I flip Delver... Alright, well, Young Pyromancer is good, but... Just play Mountain and hit. So the reason I played Mountain over Flooded Strand is even though I have Delver out and it can use card selection, I'm actually not unhappy drawing lands or most spells right now. And if I want to cast Lightning Bolt, I don't want to have to get a Volcanic. Uh-oh. Okay, well, Precursor Golem's good, but this is a, for those who aren't up on Vintage or played Scars Limited, 5 mana 3-3 makes 2 more 3-3s, good in like the mirror, but when I bolt it, they all get bolted, all of them. Alright, let's not reveal, play a land, I'm just going to play Young Pyromancer, and hit. Could have played Jace, but I'm not flipping it anytime soon, and I really like getting aggressive against workshops, just because if they have a bunch of lock pieces, just having these things out is much better. Hopefully they don't have, like, a Ballista now. Another Precursor Golem. Okay, now I want to get this Jace back. Or Jace online, rather, so I can Lightning Bolt. Alright, so we get to flip, play land. I'm just going to get an Island here. Play JVP and hit in the air for 3. Put my opponent at 15. Unless they have literally strip mine, then I'm going to get to Lightning Bolt Precursor Golems down. Okay. I'm going to take 9 here. Get to make a token off that too. And. Oh, I guess I don't. I don't necessarily get to play. Artifacts cost 1 less, sure, and artifact, sure. I don't necessarily get to flip Jace. Maybe I should have blocked with Pyromancer, I don't know. Arcbound Ravager, and they get to sack Precursor Golem. That's not good. Revoker named Jace Friend's Prodigy. Wow, I'm getting owned. Well, this is bad. I guess I'm pretty dead. They can name Jace Friend's Prodigy here. It's funny because they only drew actual one piece of, well, 2 pieces of disruption. Wasteland kind of counts, but like really just Sphere of Resistance, and that got me pretty good. If I had left Spell Pierce up, I may have been able to win this game, but I think they actually want a sac. If they sac Precursor to Arcman Ravager, Bolt does not stop it. Null Rod, huh? Put that on the bottom, I think. Put Brainstorm on top. Play a land. Pass. So, around 10. So, currently, Ravager. Let's say I block everything but the Ravager. It's a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh, geez. What is this? This can't be good for me. Whatever's going on here is extremely bad. I already think I was losing, by the way. This is like a Hangerback Walker or a Walking Ballista. Alright, just get it all out now. And we'll see how things go. Yeah, okay. I am dead. So, sideboard Areno. Oh, not Sulfur Elemental. Put those in. Take out Mental Misstep. Oh, actually, Spell Pierce on the play is fine. It's pretty bad on the draw, though. So I need to take out two more. Sulfur Elemental, I think, is pretty bad. Daze is interesting because Daze does actually work when you're on the play and they have one just Misha's Workshop, because the Workshop mana can't play for Daze mana. So I guess I do take out a Spell Pierce then. I think Daze is a little bit better and I don't want to take anything else out. All right, I would like to play first. Oh yeah, this hand is great. Mostly because I have Ancestral Recall. I mean, I'm hoping to draw into some mana sources here, but assuming I do, this hand is quite good. I see, okay, well. I didn't miss a land drop, at least. I would have really liked to just play a Delver this turn instead of just Wasteland Go, especially since it lets my opponent know that Wasteland's coming. But if they don't play something that stops me from casting Ponder, I might be able to draw something. Problem is, not having a red source means I can't kill. Like, if they play a Chalice on one or something. I guess there's only one Chalice of the Void now that it's restricted. But even, like, a Thorn of Amethyst would be pretty annoying. I guess Sphere Resistance would be a lot more annoying because I would still pay two for Ponder. Are they just going to waste my Wasteland? Soul Ring, sure. No other plays. All right. Land. So this hits a land. The problem is it doesn't hit a red land. And if I keep this... What am I doing if I keep this? I could waste their Wasteland. Problem is if I shuffle and don't draw a land, I'm just so, so far behind. If I keep this, I can play Delver. I guess. Could just play Null Rod. Alright, we're going for it. We're turning off our own Sapphire to kill their Soul Ring, and they can waste my Wasteland if they want, but they get to play like one spell. Alright, so they get to play a Workshop, but then I get to play Delver or Preordain, Foundry Inspector, sure. Alright, Preordain. Can we find red? No, bottom, red. All right, and let's Lightning Bolt Foundry Inspector. No second Wasteland? Come on, just no second Wasteland. Okay, it's not a Wasteland. Double Workshop means that... Okay, that's fine. That is fine. I have another Bolt. Land. Lands are just great. All right, no lands. Let's just play Delver. I don't think I need to Bolt yet. Because if I draw land, I can snap Ancestral, and that would be real good. Or potentially snap Bolt, depending on what's going on. Academy? Wow, that's a reason not to wait on killing Golem. Okay. Lesson learned. Metamorph. Though, actually, that worked out kind of nicely, because now I get to... So, it actually worked out better for me. Oh, wait. No, I should have let them copy it. What am I thinking? Because if I let them copy it, then I would be able to bolt all of the things. I guess they get a delver, which doesn't do that much, but... No, that was bad. Wow, I am playing very medium here, but I think I'm doing okay. All right, now I'm in the, like, either flipped over or draw land mode. Or draw one of the two artifacts left in my deck. All right, yeah, that's fine. Whatever. I'm not ingot-churing the Foundry Inspector. They have lots of mana. They can inspect all the foundries they want. They're probably not flipping their Delver. If they flip their Delver before me, off like a Dismember or something, I'm just going to lose my mind. That would be really funny. All right. I'll take it. Take it. And... What do they have? Another Precursor? No, a Worm Coil Engine? What in the world? All right. Land is at least a thing, so let's go. All right, we're going to do some grinding now. It's going to involve... My opponent's going to be gaining a lot of life. That's okay. It's going to involve Snapcaster and Sestraling. This Norrod is hurting me more than it's hurting my opponent. This is so stupid. I'm playing... Oh, man, I made some... I actually think that the decision to play Norrod was not necessarily bad. Maybe it was because they wouldn't have played Wasteland Soaring if they didn't have... Oh, no. Oh, no. Okay. Thought this was another Metamorph. All right. This is going to be a close game. I actually think it's going to be close because I'm going to chump Wormcoil with... At this point, I think I'm just going to get Volcanics. I'm going to chump Wormcoil with the token. I'm going to Snapcaster Ancestral. And then I think I'm actually ahead because my opponent's not restricting me from casting spells, and my spells are much better than my opponent's. There's just... Basically, if the blue deck can cast all their spells, they generally beat workshops. All right. Yes. See, like this actually, that's a hand that can beat workshops. All right, so block. Block. Take four. Because the workshop, or the Misha's Factory is going to pump the other Misha's Factory. But I get to go... I have Wasteland for Factory, and I get to go Pyromancer Time Walk. And then I get to start ingot-churing away things too. Can I flip a Delver while I'm at it? Apparently not. Let's go Wasteland. Pyromancer. Time Walk. Opponent's had a lot of life, but this is a pretty beefy turn. Hit. Now if I can flip Delver with a nice Treasure Cruise or something. Yeah, young Pyromancer is not exactly what I wanted. Alright, they have tons of mana, so what actually I'm going to do... Oh yeah, it's coming. It is coming. Humph. Ingot-Chur. And pass. Though I suppose I should have attacked first. Of course, if my opponent draws Walking Ballista, I'm just dead. So don't do that, please. We're having such a nice game here. No, no, no. Just be activating factory. Yeah. All right. I'm like one spell away from just exploding with triple Pyromancer here. But Walking Ballista does go in the, get in there. Actually, I think I need to Wasteland Talarian Academy just so their Walking Ballista doesn't completely just run me over. Triple Misha's Factory. That's fine. Okay. So these factories are effective 3/3s. Let's see, let's block the lifelink token. And block a death touch token, and I take five. Okay. Can live with that. This is a sweet game, not gonna lie. Alright, so now I need to flip a spell. Can I just flip like the one Gush or Ponder? I'm not even greedy, just a Preordain would be fine. Honestly. Jace Friend's Prodigy. Okay, well, yeah, actually, you know what? I can afford to take a turn off here. I'm just going to hope they don't draw Walking Ballista. Actually, I think I just... pass with. I'll leave Wasteland up. If they draw Walking Ballista, I guess I'm willing to just be dead. Because they can, even if I Wasteland at Academy, they could play Walking Ballista for 9 mana, maybe 10 if they had a land in hand. So, at that point, whatever, they have one turn to do that. Otherwise, I think I actually do just win. Because Jace lets me flashback Time Walk followed by like Ponder. And by playing Jace and then Pyromancer, I should be able to win or live through this turn, especially since I have Wasteland for one of these factories. We're at 5. All right, well, Delver is getting blocked by Jace. I know that much. And I think I chump. Yeah, I'm going to keep all the Pyromancers around. And Wasteland a factory. I hope my opponent didn't draw Phyrexian Revoker, though I guess I have Ingot Chur if it really comes down to that. I go to 3. I want to have enough life left for Force of Will. No. No. Another Worm Coil? Okay. I think I can beat the second Worm Coil, but this one's going to be a little harder. Strip Mine. Alright, so let's draw. Spell Pierce. Discard Lotus. Time Walk. It had to be second Worm Coil. Actually, I think I do this. I think I cast Time Walk, Spell Pierce it, and pay for the Spell Pierce. Because I don't think Spell Pierce is going to do very much against my opponent anymore. So might as well cash in for 2 tokens. Draw Preordain. Nice. Okay. I think that's good. Well, I could just, I can Preordain and then cast Ingot Chur afterwards, I think. All right, Preordain, Dig Through Time and Scalding Tarn. All right, put Tarn on the bottom, put Dig on top. At some point I can find By Force, right? And then that would be great. Dak Faden, ooh, Dak Faden to steal Worm Coil. Okay, so now, at 3. Alright, I can await a turn, so I'm going to take Dak Faden and Force of Will. And I think that this is the conservative play, but I like it. And then I'll plus on Worm Coil to make them, or the Death Touch token, so I can block it with a bunch. And strip Mishra's Factory and pass. Because I think I can still grind down Worm Coil with Pyromancers. I have 12 tokens right now. And this way, if they draw Hanger back, I can just force it. Because then next turn, I can Jace and flashback like a Ponder. Or just flashback Dig Through Time, actually. Like, Sphere of Resistance is fine. Trinisphere would be annoying. I can deal with Sphere. Chalice of the Void for 1. Okay. That is more than fine. And now they're not attacking? Oh, yeah. The end is near, my friend. All right. And I drew a land already, so now I can flashback Dig Through Time, because this way, I can make sure I've got Force of Will up after casting this deck. Ingot Chur, so Treasure Cruise, and I guess another Force of Will? I don't even need Ingot Chur at this point anymore. Land, Dak, Steel Worm Coil Engine. and I win! Alright, that was quite the game. That it was. Holy crap. Let's see. I really don't like Spell Pierce on the draw. At that point, I'd rather have Mind Break Trap in case they really go off, and I can just pitch that. There's also Jace the Mind Sculptor, but yeah, you just don't get up to that much mana very often, so I'll try this. Alrighty. Yeah, I've got to keep this game 3. No Force of Wills to be seen. It's going to be kind of hard to beat Workshops on the draw without Force of Will. but you got to keep this hand. It's got turn one Delver Preordain or like one of those two plus Wasteland thanks to Sapphire, so just don't play Chalice on one, I guess. Also, Mox is pretty good with Biforce. Thorn of Amethyst is annoying, yeah. What's the follow-up? Mm-hmm. Okay. That I can live with. I'm just going to name like a Dak Faden that I've won over. Black Lotus or something. I don't know. Whatever. And no other play. So, their best play with 4 mana was a Phyrexian Revoker. How bad... What could their best play with... So they could play 5 mana and they could play... I'm just going to Wasteland. Sometimes, I've heard rumors, I've never verified them, but sometimes I've heard that workshops cannot have two Misha's workshops in their opening hand. Okay, well I guess when you have Talon Academy and Ancient Tomb also, you kind of get to have more, but still. So now... Not a sphere? No, it can't be a sphere. Ravager. Okay, Ravager's annoying, but let's go Island. Pay one for Sapphire. Delver. And set up Lightning Bolt into Biforce, I think is my plan. Well, we'll see what I draw. We'll see what my opponent does. Now they have 3 mana. Okay, they're not playing anything gigantic. Sphere of Resistance. That's going to be hard. I'm blocking the Phyrexian Revoker here. If my opponent wants to sack Ravager to make Revoker a 3-2, I would love that. And... Okay, perfect. Because I can just bolt that down, which I think I will, because that'll leave my opponent with only 2 mana if they don't play a land this turn. They didn't play a land. Okay. Ooh, Treasure Cruise isn't terrible. Alright, I'm vulnerable to Wasteland now, which I don't like. But this restricts them to 2 mana, so there's just not much they can cast. Alright, don't draw Wasteland. Just don't draw lands. That's all I'm asking. Because they just can't cast anything if they don't draw land. Ooh, Black Lotus? Yes, alright. Let's play this, and then I can just cast Biforce next turn to kill all their stuff. Oh yeah, I think we're going to do it. I think we're going to get there. So let's go Biforce these two. That costs 5. Ooh, taste it. Whoa, I can cast spells without paying inordinate amounts of mana? What is it like? Oh, that's very nice, is what it's like. Alright, Preordain. Delver, Preordain. Put Delver on bottom. Preordain on top, and then Treasure Cruise. I'll leave Biforce in the graveyard because I have a lot of mana. Oof. Alright, I think we're going to win. I guess we get to play another round. How lucky. Alright, they drew their Wasteland, but at this point, it really just doesn't even matter. Yeah, they're not even using it. Alright, so now, let's go get another Volcanic. So 5 mana. Let's just start by Preordaining. There we go. I'll keep Bolt, why not? So now let's play Young Pyromancer, Time Walk, and they can just concede now if they want. Draw Bolt. They'll concede to the Snapcaster at the very least. Bottom. I'll put Norrod on the... Actually, I'll put Norrod on top, just because this way I don't even have to counter Hangerback Walker, or rather Walking Ballista. Time Walk. Time Walk. And... I don't even think I'm going to cast this Norrod, because I'll just leave... Force up with a double bolt, and I think they're just super dead. All right, we defeated workshops. Hooray. It always feels great when you defeat workshops. They're the enemy. Don't let anyone tell you otherwise. Sure. Ravager's fine. Bolt you. And bolt you. I think the one bolt might be enough. I guess technically it's not. They have dismember. And bolt you. And F6. And we get to find out whether we are going to win sweet, sweet prizes in this event. And, well, that'll be it. Next round. Let's do it. Alrighty, time for round three. Would like to play first. I've had some good matches and, ooh, hello. I swear I've drawn Mox Sapphire in like every opening hand. It's definitely not a complaint. Mox Sapphire is a great card. I am going to lead with Ancestral here. Because I do have Mental Misstep back up, and, well, this mountain's been pretty bad so far, but it does save you a sideboard slot, so I don't know. But if this gets Force of Willed, it gets Force of Willed. Well, it did not. Ooh, I like this hand, though. This hand denies mana like no one's business. I'll be able to slam Norrod Wasteland on turn two, which makes it pretty difficult for a lot of decks to cast spells. Ooh, I like saying Mox Emerald. Mox Emerald implies, I less like seeing Black Lotus. Ooh, okay, they didn't play anything? Chalice of the Void for one? What am I playing against? I don't know, but I'm going to brainstorm in response. Well, put some one drops there. This actually is kind of unfortunate because I'm not going to be able to... Well, Chalice on one is bad, but if Norrod resolves here, then we could both be screwed, so that could be nice. Am I getting mana drained? I probably am. Oh, there's just nothing I can do about that, unfortunately. I can strip mine now, but... Well, my opening hand was quite good. Turn one Ancestral, turn two Chalice, or Norrod strip mine, but my opponent had turn one Chalice plus mana drain. That could be difficult. I know I'm bricking on my next draw steps. Playing against like Red Blue Blood Moon? Sure. Abrade my Mox Sapphire? Okay. That is fine. Just gonna play my Wasteland instead of Mountain here. Because if I draw Island, I'll want to be able to cast Gush or something along those lines. Chalice for one. Getting me pretty good here. Yeah, if I had this Norrod going, I think I'd be in great shape. Mountain. Mountain's bad. And I don't really have a way game one to get rid of that Chalice. I'm just not going to be able to do anything at any point. What I need to draw is Dak Fate. That would be great. Ooh, JVP is nice. Play Wasteland. And I guess I actually have all one drops, so not that nice. As long as my opponent doesn't draw blue mana. I guess they have that Mox Sapphire, though. What is going on over there? Still not going to do a whole lot. Alright, discard, Mental Misstep. Plus Jace. Play land. I'm actually going to upkeep just hard cast Gush. I don't want to get mana drain, so I don't want them to play a land. And if they have anything that, like a Pyroblast or a... Well, I guess all the 1-drops are not around, so they can force well my Gush if they want. But all 1-drops. My deck's all 1-drops. It's going to be very hard for me to win this game. And my Norrod is gone. Which is unfortunate. Ooh, Young Peasy. That, on the other hand... That could be something here. If Pyromancer resolves, we're playing spells into Chalice just to get our Pyromancer triggers. And maybe I can just beat my opponent down while they're just doing stone nothing. And I'll keep plussing Jace and pass the turn. They're gonna braid my pyromancer or something? I mean, who knows what they're even doing? I have very low confidence that I know what's going on. This looks like a landstill type of deck. I guess I could get Jace to ultimate here. Because now I can snapcast or hardcast Gush, which is not something I've ever done before. But I think I'm going to. Gets me a pyromancer trigger plus a 2-1. Like, that is a pretty substantial game. Alright, let's just get a basic island because I don't really know what's going on. Play Snapperino. This is a weird game. My opponent played a card, Chalice of the Void, which makes it so I can't play any spells. Basically, all my spells are just dead. But in exchange, I'm going to get my token out of this. In exchange, they just did nothing for a million turns. So somehow I'm actually doing all right. And do I want to minus Jace? No, I think I'm going to plus Jace and just pass. And now I can, next turn I can ultimate Jace, which I've never done before. And then every time I play a spell, I mill them for 5. Okay. Well, I want Jace the Mind Sculptor against this deck. I actually don't want Null Rods, despite it being good there. This looks like a deck that does not have very many reasons to have Null Rod. Sulfur Elemental, I think, seems fine. Flusterstorm seems like it could be okay. I don't particularly like Lightning Bolts. And I really don't like Mental Missteps against a deck that... Well, they have Chalice, but they just can't have that many 1-drops in their deck. And I want a couple Ingot Chewers. I guess I keep a couple Missteps in. I don't know. I don't really know exactly what I'm playing against. Alright, my opponent kept 7. Oh, I'm going to keep 7 too. This is a pretty good hand. Highly disruptive. Oh, geez. Eternal Library. Alright, Wasteland. Library is going to be tough. Actually, I'm going to play the Ruby. It's unlikely, but I might want to hardcast Daze. This hand looks like it'd be great against my opponent, but Eternal Library of Alexandria, which means they're just drawing 2 cards a turn now. Say it ain't so. And Mox Sapphire. Actually kind of don't like Mox Sapphire. Let's spell pierce that. And Mental Misstep, I can pitch to Force of Will. I like that. Really would like to Ancient Tomb? Okay, Sulfur Elemental also has the potential to just beat the crap out of my opponent. Ancient Tomb makes it so Daze is less likely to be good. I guess I could have Dazed the Mox also, but I really wanted to cast Sulfur. I could have hard cast Daze. That seemed worse because I knew I was tapping out for Sulfur Elemental. No colored mana or land drop? Alright. Sulfur Elemental Flesh. Well, you can't Force of Will it. Not a whole lot you can do. Wasteland, still. Ooh, Strip Mine, I'll take it. Alright, opponent drew 2 cards off that, but their draw appears to be bad. Are they just going to play 2 games without playing a single relevant spell that affects anything? I don't know what's going on over there. Mox Ruby? I'm not going to Force of Will that, so I guess that's fine. Sol Ring? I will... I'm going to Mental Misstep that. I figure they don't have a lot of 1s, and at this point Daze is pretty dead, so I can just pitch it to Force of Will if I need to. Ooh. Young Pyromancer. I like that. If they want to force my Pyromancer, I'm just going to force back. Like, I don't know what my opponent's doing, or if they have any cards that do anything. If they force again, I guess that's fine. Okay, well, we traded off a bunch of forces. Pitched Dig Through Time. So presumably they're interested in casting spells that are relevant. But they have 2 cards in their hand now. All colorless mana sources. I have a Lightning Bolt in hand and a Sulfur Elemental. I'm just going to kind of get them. What is this? I hope it's not a way to kill Sulfur Elemental. Rolling Earthquake for two? I guess I'm glad they fought over Pyromancer. Alright. So now we're on pretty even terms in terms of cards, but I can actually cast spells and they cannot. Force means I can counter their first bit of nonsense. But I guess the Blood Moon? I guess I have to force that. I don't really want to, because Blood Moon's not actually good against me. Like, I have a lot of islands and fetches to get islands, but... Oh, I'm glad I countered it. I kind of have to. Now I think I'm winning by a lot. Because if I draw any mana source and can just cast Jace, they have to have another Force of Will. Alright, now I'm going to get basic island. Well, snow covered, but it counts as basic for the purposes of Blood Moon. Jace... Just gonna +2 on my opponent. They might have like Lightning Bolt or Rolling Earthquake. Scalding Tarn, I'll put that on the bottom. Also, I wanted to deny them blue mana. The only way this is bad is if they have Pyroblast. Or like something weird like Phyrexian Revoker. Alright, now I'm gonna start brainstorming. 6. Yeah, this is... I just get to do it all. Alright, Wasteland, Ancient Tomb... Played Delver, which has a Lightning Bolt on top. So Delver's lethal, Sulfur Elemental's lethal, Sudden Shock kills my Delver, and I can't do anything about it, sure. So they're pretty dead. They have to have something pretty incredible to not die. Chalice for one. Well, they don't die. The Lightning Bolt's no longer lethal, but Sulfur Elemental's lethal in two turns here. And now Pyromancer, I guess, actually I shouldn't have played Pyromancer, I suppose, because this way they could draw Rolling Earthquake and cast it for two, but I don't know, I feel like I'm not super worried. I don't really, no, it's better to play this. They have more Sudden Shocks in their deck than Rolling Earthquakes. Trinket Mage, okay. This is like a blue-red Blood Moon control deck. Kind of sweet. Kind of sweet indeed. But, yeah, they're dead. Like, I get to Jace, bounce Trinket Mage. They can get Lotus, I guess, and maybe play something cool. I'm not sure what, though. Mox Jet? Why not Mox Sapphire? What is going on? I'm confused. What? I bolted Trinket Mage instead of my opponent when they're at 3? No, Chalice the Void is going to counter it anyway. So if they have Sudden Shock, I just go... Whoop. And that should do it. Yeah. Boom. We went 3-1 with the blue-red Delver. That goes sweet. That match against Workshops was great. So, alright, this was good times. I don't know if this is better than a Mentor deck. And probably not, but I like Norod, Wasteland, and a lower curve. Probably better against Workshops, I will say that.